Hello everyone, in this video I will be showing you the slot machine that I built. Let's first give it a run through, see what happens, and after that I will explain how exactly it works. To start the slot machine, all you have to do is click the giant letters that say click here, and quickly disable and enable the synchronize with adjacent stations option. And eventually a while after that, you should see three colors popping up here. It takes a while, so I'll speed it up a bit for you. There we go, two reds and one orange. Sad we didn't get three red, would have won $1 million. Now I will show you how the slot machine works step by step. The first step is getting three guests onto three different paths. For that I've built this orange car ride, which is the same as the one as the letters. And as you can see, it has four stations, but only three stations are actually part of the ride. However, when you enable the synchronize with adjacent station settings, the cars will not depart because there is no car in a forced station. However, so if you disable that option, you can see that the cars will depart. And since they all have one guest in them, they will leave from different exits, you get three guests on three different paths. After a guest exits the station, he gets onto a path. There are three layers, as you can see, but all hide the top two. Then he gets to choose between eight different car rides. As you can see, he walked and he can't go back, these are no entry signs. And he chooses a red one. Now he gets in the car ride, which is also set to wait for full load and synchronize with adjacent stations. If a station only has an exit, it will ignore the wait for full load part. But this one will only depart if it has a guest in it, which in turn also sets off this steel wild mouse with the lift car as a car, which is also synchronized with the same stations, which will then send the lift car via this black and white track all the way to the front. And the other two guests have also chosen. This time we got two reds and one blue. When the lift cabins get to the front, they'll stay there for a while. You can see I've set minimum and maximum waiting time to 80 seconds, which is for some reason not actually 80 seconds, but more about a minute, which gives you plenty of time to see what combination you got and see if you've won anything. When the 80 seconds are gone, the cabins will return to the other station. And if you then wait a while, so that 80 seconds there are also gone, you can play again. As you may have noticed, I've used a lot of cheats to make this possible. So now I will give a rundown of which cheats I used. The most important one is disable clearance checks. If you disable those, the game will not check if there's already something in the way of where you're trying to build. That has allowed me to build as closely as possible as I've done, to build right through itself and all the things that normally wouldn't be possible, but because there would be things in the way. The other one in this little drop-down menu that I've used is disable support limits, because it's just slightly too tall for the Wild Mouse coaster, but now I don't have to worry about that. As you can see, the stats of these car rides, these small car rides, aren't exactly great, and guests will most likely not ride them. So I've used a cheat that guests ignore the intensities of rides, so they will ride any ride they encounter, most of the time. Here you can see another four cheats that I used. The first one is allow chain lifts on all track pieces, which has allowed me to put chain lifts on all the Wild Mouse rides to get the lift cabins to the front a lot sooner. The second one is unlock operating limits, which allows me to set the chain lift to 120 km per hour, once again to get cabins to the front faster. After that we have disable all breakdowns, just to make sure the rides don't break down, because that would break the slot machine. And the last one is show vehicles from other track types, which allows me to put the lift cabin on the Wild Mouse ride. I could just use the cars and color them, but lift cars are nice, big and square, so they're more easy to see. The last cheat I've used is a tile inspector, which I've used to make all the track piece and station piece in front of this wall invisible. As you can see, there are a lot of track pieces here, and all of them have a corrupt element below them. If I remove those, you can see that they become visible again. Oh, and one last other cheat that I used is to make the weather always sunny. I've frozen the climate to sunny because it's not fun working in the rain. Sadly, there's still one bug in this machine, and I cannot solve it. The game doesn't give me the options to. Sometimes when a guest arrives at the entrance of the small car ride, it will already think that it wants to go home and it can't find the park exit, and then it will not ride it. So sometimes you just get two lift cabins in the front, or worse, even one, even though chance that's very small. I've never had that happen to me. That's just something you have to deal with. Can't help that. That was about it. The save file's in the description if you want to play around with it yourself. And thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.